y'all. Welcome back to Knitting in Our Jeans. I'm Liz.
And I'm Carolyn.
And we're happy to have you back if you're a returning watcher. And
God
welcome.
Bless your little heart.
And welcome if you are new. Absolutely. Thank you for finding us. Let us know either in the description or in the Ravelry thread how you found us.
I do answer comments. We had one last week about your Find Your Fade, so I put all the links to the, I think I named all of the colors is I did. So I went into your Ravelry project page, easy for me to say, and I put all of that down in the down bar. So yes, we do answer comments. So that's good. And who
Mom
are
generally,
you, by the way?
Oh, I'm Too Liz For You, TOOLIZZFORYOU, on both Ravelry and Instagram. Usually you tell me about comments.
I forwarded it to you.
You forwarded the one from Mary. You didn't forward the fade one.
All right.
From me. That's
no,
okay.
I did the fade.
You did it, and it's fine, but usually it's a, we have a comment. How do I answer it?
Well, I
because
how
Mom
to
is in charge of the YouTubing.
Yeah.
Because it works out better that way.
Oh, sure it does.
It does!
Anyway, I'm
done.
I am CPREDMOR on YouTube and, well, Ravelry.
And Instagram.
Instagram. Forget, no, I'm Knitting in Our Jeans on where are we? YouTube.
YouTube.
It's one of those days.
We're having a day.
We are having a day.
I didn't wake up till noon.
And
I don't know how. I never sleep that late.
Your father, well, because we were up till 2:30 last night.
We were. That show is so good.
It is good. We really like that.
Escape to the country. It's like House Hunters, but in Britain, in the country, and they always show them under the budget.
Well, no. The one guy does a little bit over the budget.
Just a little bit. But, like, it's not like House Hunters or House Hunters International, where it's like thousands, tens of thousands over the budget.
No, they're really pretty good. So we were staying up, and I knew I had been buttered last night at dinner. We have a new rule, no vegetables for me when we're eating out, unless I know that they're crudités and they've only been soaked in water, because I've had quite
butter.
A night. There was butter, and now I have a headache that's right about here, and I know it's not going to go away till tomorrow, so whatever.
Yay!
So yes, we've got ginger ale floating around here. We've got all kinds of stuff. I've taken the Motrin. I've taken whatever I can take, and hopefully it will lift.
So
but
we're
it's only
a little
on one
lengthy.
Side of my head, not both sides of my head, so it's better than it could be, so that's fine. I have a finished object.
I have two finished objects.
You
technically
do.
I have three finished objects. Well,
do
I told
you, have
you
them
I
with
took,
you?
I do.
Do you want to show them?
Did I tell you? Well, this is because I took a mental health day on Friday, because if you live in the New York area, you will know that there was a power outage at 53rd and 7th at 7:30 in the morning on Friday morning. You want to know when they posted, when MTA posted it on their Twitter, which is the first place they post these issues? 8:30.
Yeah.
You want to know when I got on the train? 7:40. Want to know how long it took me to get into Manhattan? 2 hours. Guess who didn't go to work, because I was so mad. I was, and there was no point in me going in on a Friday as angry as I was.
I think
so,
you need to let these things go.
I do. I'm
trying
to.
I would have gone in, and I would have gone to Nitty City, or I would have gone to a yarn place, and I would have made myself very happy. Then I would have wandered into work.
See, I made myself very happy by finishing things.
Well, I can see that, but, you know.
Yeah,
I
know.
I'm
you
of a generation of, you've got to get to work. Oh, that's pretty.
I know.
I've
that's
seen
that. Yes, you have.
And I lusted after it before.
Yes.
Yes.
So,
oh!
I finished the socks! So, they're done.
They're so pretty.
Thank you. I do have to, so I didn't Kitchener the toe, because I was not in a headspace to Kitchener, so I did just three needle bind off,
right.
Which I think is fine.
You know what I found? If I turn it inside out
and then three
do the,
needle bind off,
then it's really smooth on the outside.
Yeah, I thought about doing that, but then again, I wasn't sure I had enough mental capacity to do that, because I thought of that, because Gigi and Jasmine on the Knitmores talked about that a few days ago, because, oh, yes, on this two-hour commute, I listened to three back episodes of the Knitmores, which is fine and lovely, but that's when I was, when I finished the last of my Knitmore stash, I was like, ha! Ha! I'm still on the train. What?
It happens to me a lot. I get stuck in traffic.
Yes, but you get stuck in traffic, but you're in a car. Like, your travel time is changeable no matter what.
Yes.
The train, I get on the train, or I leave my apartment, and I can get into the office within 50 minutes.
It's impressive.
So, well, 50 whatever. Minutes is the most it's taken to get to the office.
I'm just saying this is likely to happen in the future.
I know.
Have a better coping mechanism.
I know. I think I just had a bad week. Okay. But they're done.
They're beautiful.
I'm going to give them to my friend in a week.
Perfect.
I have to finish putting together
perfect,
a few
perfect.
Other things for her.
Yes.
And then I finished my swap, first swap project. I don't think my swap nerd watches this, and if she does, I'm really, really sorry.
Clothes.
But look.
Oh, wow.
It's a cowl. It's a capelet. And she had said she really is interested in these cowl capelet fads. And so it's nice and cozy. She's from Virginia, Richmond, I believe. And so I think this will be lovely for the winter. I will have to weave in ends. I did not weave in ends.
No,
but it's in, this is a nerd, they're both in Nerd Girl. This is Nerd Girl Rant, which is super smooshy and lovely and fluffy.
It's like a roving.
It's a nicely spun single. Mm. It's a tightly spun single. And it's really nice.
It's that tight.
I mean, it's pretty tight. I don't
it's
end
a little
up,
thicker than roving.
A little thinner than roving, I'd say.
Okay.
It's spun.
I bet we could spin it.
I bet you could.
Yeah.
But it's in BBE, Blue Box Exploding by Nerd Girl. And Mom saw what I need to... Mom saw what I brought that I need to
skein?
Cake up.
That's
it's
gorgeous.
Clawed on Heart You. It's going to be a star shower for her as well, because it's
cool.
a cowl capelet kind
nice.
Of thing. And that should go out next week.
Excellent.
I also need to set up the quilting thing. Oops. I'm making a quilt kit. Remember I told you?
Oh,
that?
Right.
That.
So I have a finished object.
I know.
That's
dripped,
very...
it dripped onto... Let's just say she blocked it, and she is blocking it currently. She has it hanging off the table. Isn't it so pretty?
And that pooling part...
It's so pretty!
It's really pretty. It's kind of over the bust, which you'd think would be really bizarre, but I
Rainbow
tried it on...
Rainbow boobs!
Yeah, I tried it on last night, and it really does look good.
Yeah.
So I've got...
I might have not have yelled that at my mother last night when
not.
She tried it.
So I've got a blocking wire at the bottom, and I'm stretching out the lace so it'll look nice, and...
It's really very lovely, except for the fact that it was better than Mother had anticipated, so she has it hanging off the table here, and I go... To take a look at it,
and
I stepped
in
the puddle.
It's only been up here like 10 minutes, or it's already making
my toe
puddle.
Is still cold.
So, oh, poor baby. It's a good thing it's warm outside.
Yeah.
So, so it should be dry by Tuesday or so.
Yeah.
I didn't put it in a towel and stomp on it, so that's part
that's
of the problem.
That's probably part of it.
Because I was doing this at about 1:30,
yeah.
2 o'clock. So, what else do you have over here?
So, I've been working on the...
my fox.
No, your fox is over here.
Okay, thank you.
I've been working on the 6312516 cowl.
Ooh.
So, I've gotten through clue one, and I'm working on clue two.
That's really nice.
Thank you. It's out of the Barocco Folio.
Mm-hmm.
I think the colors are a little mute. Like, they look a little bit more muted knit up than they are... In the ball.
In the cakes? Okay.
But that's okay. I still think it's really pretty. It might end up going in the random gifts box. I don't know. I'll see how I feel about it when I'm done with it.
Sounds good.
But I've been working on that.
I love this.
I picked this up because I kind of realized how many works in progress I have. And I'm not allowed to cast on anything else until I get a few more of my smaller things done because I need to not have some work.
Oh, I want to say that I love the sleeve on this because what you do, it's a set in sleeve, but you knit it contiguous with, you knit it into the sweater once the armhole is done.
Mm.
So you leave, I think it's something like 8 stitches live. And so you come back, you join your yarn and you knit those and then you knit up one side of the arm's eye, mark the center at the top, and then come back down. No, and then you do a short or this way, short or this way, and you're adding a stitch each
mm-hmm.
each row because with a yarn over, and then you knit that together the next row, or you purl it together the next row, and it makes a, this beautiful set-in sleeve that's not really poofy.
Oh, it is beautiful.
I hate poofy sleeves on short
sleeves.
That
is really beautiful.
And it's the biggest problem I have with my summer sweaters that they have these added... I hate them. So anyway, I
really... They're the worst.
They are the worst. I have big arms anyway. I mean, that's... It's not so bad here, but up here, they're fat. And either I get rid of the fat or do something. But anyway, I don't need to emphasize the fact that I've got these massive upper arms. It's like 16 and a half inches across anyway. We're like fullbacks here.
Yeah, we're if you couldn't tell, we're...
You know... I'm the Hulk, except I'm in red. I look like this because I'm going off to help my husband with the boat. I'm going to be scrubbing a deck in preparation. We're hoping that it'll go in the water this weekend, which is another problem with getting my hair done. So anyway, there's a family wedding next weekend, so we won't be podcasting because we'll be driving back from the Jersey Shore, which will probably take 7 hours.
Good luck.
Talk about your subway trip. Anyway, I do love these sleeves. Oh,
they're pretty great.
Yeah.
I'm definitely thinking
those.
We should
so
just
I'm gonna
have those
highlight
as our sleeve.
That in my favorites as sleeves.
Yeah, and just use that on all of our shorts.
I love
things.
It.
That's great.
I love it. Absolutely.
That's pretty great.
So you have a hat.
So I have this hat that I've been working on, and it's the Strandvander. Stravangerlua. It's Norwegian, I think.
2015.
Yeah. It's free, and it's beautiful. It's, you're supposed to do it with four colors. I'm doing it with three. I got three pigtails from Oink at Rhinebeck.
Yes.
And so, you have the cut, the brim, you have your background color, you have a stripe, you have a flower. Ooh, the flower looks really good on
camera. Looks
really
nice, yeah.
And then up here, this is the beginnings of a big rose motif.
Cool.
So I am, I'm about to start row 29 of 46.
Not bad.
Of the chart. And then at row.
Did you count those socks as two finished objects?
I said I had two, technically three finished objects because I had two socks.
I see. I just wondered.
I was not technically counting them as a third, but at the same time, I finished three things.
Checking my math here.
It's all good.
Okay.
It's all good. Or as we said, we're having one of those days. but yeah, I'm trying to truck along on it because it's really cute and it's really pretty and I think it'll be really nice. And I'm pretty happy with my tension of my floats along the back.
I like them. They're nice and loose. It should be able to fit on your head. My head.
Or your head, yes. So I like it. I want it done. Because
well,
it's so pretty. So it's working up pretty quickly. I ended up doing about six or so rows last night. So maybe I can just sit and do them.
That'd be nice.
I also have the, Same thread. I still have the pincha shawl. I still have a few other things that need to get done.
Speaking of Rhinebeck.
Yes.
I had been listening to Sockmantician, and this is back a couple episodes. He had said, I think he said, that he was thinking about going to be at Rhinebeck this fall. I could be wrong. You know, these are old ears. I could have been hearing what I wanted to hear.
Because I am unfortunately deserting mother for Rhinebeck this year.
So anyway, I was listening to Sockmatician's most recent episode, and he and Ben got married in a musical. I mean, all legal, but they had it timed to be the first day of legal gay marriages in Great Britain. And he said, I have never been able to find the video of this because I'm not in Great Britain. So he said, well, if anybody would like to have, you know, a bigger look at this, he apparently has a bigger piece of it. So I said, oh, great. I sent him a message and I said, oh, by the way, I'm going to be at Rhinebeck. So if you're going to be at Rhinebeck, it's not like I'm from the area, but I figure I don't want you to be lonely, and I'd be more than happy to go out to dinner with you. In fact, it could be my treat. But then if you're going with Ben, you're probably not going to be lonely anyway. So sorry for the ramble, but there's my offer. And I got a lovely note back, you know, with his bigger piece of his wedding, and I really can't wait to see it. He's such a love.
We will have to watch that before
yes,
I go
Yes, and
home.
Then he and Ben are going to be in New York City in August, which is great. I mean, it's all positive.
I think you might have heard August and thought he said October.
It could be. But we're going to be sailing for part of that. So it probably will be my luck that he'll be here in New York City when I'm on a boat. Oh, well, you know.
Yeah, probably.
So anyway, but lovely man sent me a note back within 12 hours of my rambling note to him. So anyway, just a heads up on that. He will be here in August with Ben. Apparently, and you know, I've not spoken to either one of them. It's the strangest thing. You watch people's podcasts and you think that you're having this conversation and somehow they've never been a party to the conversation. Mm-hmm. But in my head, we're friends. So, well, and he's the reason that I'm trying to do the double knitting. So anyway, should I talk about what I'm working on?
You should talk about what you're working on.
I tried making the Zadie dress. I showed you the pattern last week.
It's a beautiful pattern.
It is a beautiful pattern.
She finished the muslin yesterday.
I did. That's why I was up till about 2:30 last night. Part of the reason.
That only took us till about 12.
12:30.
Dad was still up.
Was he?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it turns out that the bodice front is really short on me. So in order for it to fit me, the shoulders would have had to been about here.
Yeah.
And that was without any seam allowance.
Yeah.
That was with the pattern pieces abutting each other. And otherwise, my waist is not...
It's two inches.
Bust line.
It's two and a half inches.
Too short.
Too short for mom. So, of course, I'm sitting there and I'm trying to figure out why this isn't working. I'm so confused as to why this isn't working.
And you put it on.
So I put it on.
It fit.
I had a very thin undergarment on, so there was very little push-up happening. So I put it on, and it's a little snug, but the waist is only about half inch off of my waist.
Maybe half inch. It wasn't so bad.
And
it was long enough, and so it was the perfect proportions, almost perfect
proportions. But I'm short-waisted.
Very short-waisted.
I'm extremely short-waisted.
6 inches between your bust and your waist? Yeah, 6 inches. She has gone to...
Amy Herzog.
Amy Herzog's fit to
bladder class. And I was a little bit chubbier then, and that's when I get a little bit chubbier, my waist to bust ratio shrinks. Then it was 4 inches at the time. And now I'm a little less chubby. And it's about 5 or 6 inches. But I still need to put in double bust darts in order to make my sweaters fit, she suggests. I haven't really modified any patterns to use the double bust darts yet. Mostly because most of the patterns I've done have been looser or they've been cabled.
Right, and
so
that pulls it all in.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I'm not short-waisted. I think she gets the short-waistedness from her dad because she certainly gets her legs from her dad.
Yeah.
They're like up to her neck.
Yeah.
So I think it's a pattern that's for somebody else, but not for me. Like for somebody else, not for me because I don't have a short waist. So I'm going to be wearing a dress that I already have to go to the wedding on.
The Sherbert one would be pretty. You think you wore it for Easter? The wrap dress?
I could wear that, or I could wear the one I wore for Grandpa's birthday.
Either works.
That one. Either
one. I really
one.
Love that Sherbert one on
it. Oh, all right.
I don't know. I think it's because I could never pull off that kind of color.
Could be.
I think
that's true.
It's too pale for me.
So I do have two dresses, one of which I made and it's silk, and the other, which is also silk, but of a different texture.
Yeah.
That I got from...
Max Mara,
yeah, years and years ago. What I liked about Max Mara is that, one, they fit this rather European hip-to-waist measurements, well, Italian hip-to-waist measurements that we have, and they seem to wear like iron. My first jacket that I got from them eons ago, well, 1998, I can tell you exactly when, I still have it, and it fits, and it's great, and it's been through the wars, and it's wonderful. So anyway.
All my dress pants that we got.
They're great.
Was that high school?
Yes.
Oh.
Well,
that
no,
was,
maybe first year of college, something like that. Anyway.
We were at the old house. I think it was high school.
Could be high school. Anyway, I went back.
Yeah.
And
looked
at my Myrna.
You did?
And we tried it on last night. And we decided that these armholes are not over large for an over sweater. They would be terrible for a sweater that's a pullover or something like that. Mm-hmm. Obviously, my needle has gone awry. So we decided that keep going. I do think I'm not going to take it in anymore. I've already done 5 of the decrease rows. And I'm going to leave
it.
9. Mm-hmm. And I'm just going to go straight down till I hit the length. And then I'll circle back and do the sleeves. So this is back on a front burner. And then the other thing, whoops, let's not drag the yarn over the wet stuff. We paid for this. This is a Susan
Fox.
Susan B. Anderson toy. The Woodland Fox.
He's so freaking
cute. He's very cute. A friend of ours, I think we mentioned her daughter, is going into the hospital this week. And I'm going to run to Michael's to get some
Orangey red. Red Heart or Karen?
Yeah, yarn. Because
acrylic.
Acrylics. Because then it can be washed. Because she's only 7. 7 or 8. I believe it's 7. But anyway, she's young. And she might love this fox to death. One could only hope. And so I have polyester stuffing, and this way everything can go right into the washer and into the dryer. Because the wool that I was going to use
doesn't have a label.
No tag.
So we don't know if it's super wash or not.
We have no idea. So I'd rather let them just be able to do whatever they want with it rather than worry about it.
And have to worry about spot cleaning?
Yes. And then Harry Potter Knitting and Crocheting Club is about to start up again May 1st. And May 1st, I think, is a Monday.
Yep. Because yes. Your birthday is a Tuesday.
Yes. So I'm going to set my alarm
for 2:45.
Well, I know, but I don't have to go to work early on Monday.
I was
going to
say, you don't have...
I'm not teaching on Monday. I'm working in the dental office on Monday, so I can sleep to all the way to 8 o'clock. So I can set the alarm for 2:45, and I can submit my OWL, so hopefully it'll get approved within a day or so. Because what I want to do is I want to make the Aiken, which is from this Nora Gagan. And it is that pattern. And... which is semi-straight, and I'm thinking what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to move some of this cabling up to the waist. I'm going to tell my committee all about that. And then, starting that hip, I want to, like, bring it out just a little. And so what I may be doing, I may be making my size, then the next bigger size, then the next bigger size in terms of increasing to bring it down here. I have 9 skeins of the solid, this,
which is
Plum Street Fiber Art Cream Puff DK MCN 230 yards, and it's superwash merino at 10% cashmere, 10% nylon, and it's called Cobalt, like that makes sense. And then I have this, which was a Nerd Girl
t-shirt.
Yeah.
I think that's t-shirt.
And I have done, my swatches. So, and I'm glad I did, because the needle size that was called for in the Aiken pattern is a 9. And I wasn't getting close to gauge with the 9. So I went down to an 8, and I am spot on. And I am spot on
in both.
So nice. Here's my swatch with t-shirt. And they are just perfect. So I'm going to take pictures of all my yarn and the picture of the pattern, and I'll be able to submit that. And I'm very excited about that. So I have my Myrna that I can work on now. I have the Fox I can work on now. I've got innumerable other works in progress. But then the weather here has been rather up and down.
Yes.
And we had an accepted student's day on Wednesday that was cold, wet, and rainy.
Uh-huh.
And so I pulled out a red turtleneck sweater of mine to put on, and there's a hole in it. I think we must have some kind of little moth or something running around the house. So, of course, I'm going to fix it. I'm going to go in with some thread and fix it. But the next thing I did was come running in here to my wall. And this is what I pulled out.
It's so pretty.
This is Neighborhood. And yes, I know it's not solid red, but it's got speckles. And I can wear it in the same way that I was wearing the turtleneck, and I plan to make a substitute turtleneck out of this, and I have four more skeins underneath all of that. And it's called Basquiat, and I got it at Rhinebeck this year. So I have 1,600 yards. It's 100% superwash merino, 6 to 7 stitches to the inch on a US 1 or 2.
But, Studio sock.
Studio sock. And I think that this will be perfect. So yeah. This is going to be worked on over the summer. And I know some people don't like to have something that's made out of wool on their lap. But this way, when I finish it, I can wear it pretty soon afterwards.
We don't seem to have that problem.
I don't get hot. I can have
blankets
on in the summer, and I will be fine. So I have that. And then I thought, oh, and then I have the blanket that I need to finish. That's right under
here.
Yeah,
I see that.
I should finish that. There's innumerable other things. Mm-hmm. We're not going to go into that. But I figure if I finish the Myrna, that'll be one whip out and get those needles out. I don't think the fox will take very long, so that'll be good. And maybe by the time I finish the fox, maybe there'll be a couple more days left of April. Although, I don't know. There's a wedding next weekend.
Car knitting.
Well, there's car knitting, although your father likes to have me drive some part of the way. You know, he gets tired now. But I could bring my featherweight with me.
Yeah.
But maybe this fall I could finish the featherweight. That would be good. That would be really good because I could use it. I mean, I started because I could use it.
Mm-hmm.
I should finish it because I could use it. And then maybe get one more whip done. I also want to start designing that that scarf. I signed up for a craftsy class in double knitting. Aiden Quinn, I think his name is, listed that he had a lesson in double knitting a 2-pattern double knit, which is exactly what this would be in order to get the nevertheless
going the correct direction.
Going the correct direction. So I figure finish the fox. I can then do a gauge swatch on our colors so I get figure out what fabric I want out of this, and then make the graph paper. What I really like is being able to make the graph paper so that it has the same numbers to the inches I'm getting stitches to the inch, because then I can see the size of this thing. See being the operative word.
Yeah, she still doesn't have her new glasses
well
yet.
Not only that, but I mean just mentally figure this kind of thing out. A cohort in crime of mine, Dr. Aurora, had me assigned to me getting some really specific information, and that's really not where my talents lie at all. And then, of course, so I handed in my part, which gave her a springboard to do some more, and I feel very bad about that, but what she asked me to do, it just is not in my wheelhouse at all. And I did find a report that I could have downloaded, but, you know, a spare $5,000 for a frickin' report is not up my alley. Anyway, in a recent knitting magazine, and I think it's Vogue. I think it's the one that's on the steps. I'll have to look at it. They're talking about knitting for women. And so we know that it's KnitPro that's in India, the wooden ones.
I think so.
I think KnitPro makes their wooden needles in India with a factory that's mostly populated by women. Anyway, there's an Australian clothing designer that has a cooperative of about 100 women who are knitting like fiends. And she, you know, they're paid workers, and not knitting at home, but knitting at a place of business so that they have a place of business. And she talks about how, you know, they feel empowered, and now they're going and talking to their kids. Teachers and all this other kind of stuff. And I realized that part of what was bothering me was that some of these ideas that we had for the project that we're going to be working on in May and June didn't include any special consideration for women. And I think that's important. So if any of you out there are designers who actually have clothing that we put up for sale, that having people knit down in the Amazon might be a way to get, pay them fairly for their labors, and then also get some clothing out that could be sold. or decorative pieces or something like that, because the job opportunities for women, as far as I can tell at the moment, are kind of few and far between. So anyway, that kind of hit my brain, and I'm going to show it to Dr. Aurora on Tuesday or so and see. I mean, part of the issue is that we're doing this project with another school, and they may not want to look at this, but this may be something that I could take up under a banner, and I think it certainly is LaSallian in nature, and I can take it to Brother Jack, and maybe Brother Jack would bite on this. You never know.
Yes, because you need another project.
I know. Well, we had lunch on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Friday? No. Lunch on Wednesday with a couple members of the administration from Bethlehem University in Palestine. And I basically gave them my online class. So because Palestine doesn't let any of the college students take online classes.
Okay.
They have not fully subscribed to the idea that they're real classes. I wrote a 13-week class. So I've sent it to the assistant provost down there and say, look,
nice.
You can try this. I'll be happy to work with you, whatever you want. And I sent a copy to Brother Jack. So we'll see if anything comes of that. Yes, I have a small problem with volunteering. It's a definite problem. So anyway, this is a substitute sweater. Obviously, I need to wash all my sweaters and put them in plastic bags again. I didn't have this problem with plastic bags. My dresser is God knows how old, so yeah. It might be something within the wood of the dresser. Or I could have worn it out, but it didn't look like a wear-out spot. I could have caught it on something.
Knowing us, you could have caught it.
I could have caught it on something, so that's a possibility.
You and I do find random bruises.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. I go home last week after podcasting, and I look, and I've got a bruise right here.
I didn't hit you.
I know. And I have no idea how it happened, but oh well.
Yes. Let's see. Anything else going on?
I was going to say something, and now, speaking of things I'm working on.
Yes. Was I?
Well, we were going through what we're working on.
Yes, we were.
We have officially released registration for the Nerd Girls.
Cool.
So that is
happening.
I wish
I could go, but I can't.
I know. It's school. It's September 7th through 10th in Independence, Missouri.
It's what, 10 days before Rhinebeck?
No, it's a month.
Oh, that's right. Thank
September.
You. Sorry.
It's a month before Rhinebeck. It's the weekend after, or it's the Thursday, it's the Friday, Saturday before or after Labor Day. We've been working on this for about just under a year now.
Mm-hmm.
We have a hotel and we have a hotel block.
Nice.
We've got a meeting room. I don't know, but I know that we're capping registration at 70 people.
Okay.
So if you would like to come, get that registration in. It's all through Nerd Girl.
I would love to meet Krista.
I know.
I would love to meet Krista. I'd love to interview Krista.
If it works this year and we make it, you know, it all works out and we end up
making it an annual event.
Yes.
That would be nice. So one of these days I will retire.
She says, then I don't believe her at all.
Well, it just depends on how depressed I am at work. You know, this whole thing with doing research out of my wheelhouse was somewhat demoralizing.
Right.
You know.
So if
I really
you...
need a keeper and or a cohort in crime, so what can I tell you?
So, which is why we do this together.
Together, yeah.
So what I was going to say was, if you're in the Independence, Kansas City area, you're more than welcome to come. If you're not in the area and you would like to come, fly in. We do have a thread in the Nerd Girl forum for the retreat.
Will come.
Maybe. I should reach out.
I think you should.
I think
Amber
one of the
Lindemann.
Girls, actually, one of the girls is friends with Amber. I should reach out to, remember who mentioned it. Someone mentioned it because I had mentioned.
She seems delightful and seems to like these kinds of things.
Yeah, and I had mentioned that I wanted to, that she had talked about these little like ballet flat socks.
Yes.
The socks that I love for
yes.
Dress shoes. Because sometimes wearing stockings under jeans. I don't wear stockings under jeans, but I want to wear dress shoes with my jeans. That makes sense, right?
Yes.
So had to make sure what my brain was saying was right was right.
Yes.
So what I wanted, so what I bought from Target were the little footy socks. Some people wear them with their sneakers. I do not. I wear regular little, I wear ankle socks with my sneakers, or I wear full size socks and have the pants that, you know, cover part, the top part of my jeans or my shoes. But I do wear the little footy socks with my new Converse, because I have the low-top Converse. But Amber was talking about making these little footy socks out of scraps and out of the little ends, and I was like, that's brilliant! So I posted about that in Nerdgirl, and someone was like, oh, I know Amber from, you know, and I was like, oh, well, we should reach out.
Should
we
reach out? Yes.
We have four classes set up. All taught by other members of the group. It's kind of going to be, it's a little bit more workshoppy this year because we wanted to keep costs low. We wanted to just see if we could do it. So we have a sweaters class. So pretty much we have one woman who's going to do like an intro to sweaters. So if you've never knit a sweater before, this is an intro. And then we have two women, T-Knit Pearl and,
Langdweer,
who both are very good at modifying sweaters and how to modify sweaters for yourself. There's a lot of other women in our group who are also good at that, so I think we're all going to be at the lecture so that we can each work with whoever needs
help.
That'd
be helpful.
There's going to be a class by Krista that is it's what fiber works best for what kind of project.
Oh my gosh. It'd be nice to write that down.
Yeah. We're also gonna try and have some video done, either just via webcam or something else. I haven't really figured the details out for that. For those of our group who can't make it, we have two women who are expecting little ones in the next month, so we do not believe that they will be able to make it in September since they will have wee little ones. And then one of our girls is buying a house. And unfortunately the budget for the retreat has now gone to the budget for the house.
Of course.
You know, a couch is kind of more important than, you know, our retreat.
Yes, it is.
So we all understand.
The first thing that we bought was a couch that was long enough for me to lay down and for Richard to have a seat or vice versa.
Yeah. So that was a recent thing she said. So I think we're going to try and set something up. We have a group called Nerd Girl Yarns Retreat, but we also have a thread within the Nerd Girl Yarns group. And we have a how to prep your fiber and spin a gradient kind of class.
Oh, nice.
By Kate Black, Oh, my goodness. She was Kate Black on Ravelry, and now she's Misanthropy Knits. She's also a designer of shawls and such, and she had a baby about a year ago. So she's bringing the little one.
Cool!
I think little one is going to be staying with grandma, though, because it's little one's, I think, birthday as well that weekend.
Grandma's close by?
Grandma is close by for her, so that's why she can bring little one. Mm-hmm. Yes, so that's also why she can bring little one. But I'm just, if anyone is interested, please register, come visit. We're super excited about this. It has been a bit of a labor of love trying to get this all together, and it's a bit of a labor of love for our entire group.
No one's getting paid. No one does this for a living.
No.
Certainly.
One of the women who's helping, who is coordinating the hotel registrations, she does do this for a living. She coordinates meetings for a living. So that was really great that she stepped up, and
that's lovely.
I really appreciate it. And Krista has just, she's been working her tail off to do, you know, the back end to get the registration up and get registration stuff
at some point, because she's just a host of information.
She's amazing. So if anyone's interested, I know I just rambled for a little bit, but
we'd love to have you come.
It's definitely something that is very
she'll
close
be there.
To my
I
heart.
Won't, but she'll
yeah,
be there.
I just
half
bought
of,
my
half of knitting in our jeans
yes,
will be there. You
I just
ticket?
I just bought my ticket.
Very nice.
You will have to come pick me up at the airport on Sunday.
Sunday what?
The 10th.
Okay.
I'm getting
what
a
time?
6 a.m. flight, so probably like 9 or 10 o'clock.
In the morning?
Yeah.
On Sunday?
Yeah.
Sure. Okay. No
it
choice
was,
that day.
It was $60 less.
Wow. All right.
I
well,
figured
we all know
$60
about
was either three skeins of yarn or dinner,
it
so.
Makes sense. Oh, and for the yarn crawl, I won a prize.
Oh!
I don't know what it is yet.
No.
I think it's I think it's a class. Someone, I think, said it was a class at Bug Knitting Live. But we'll see.
I didn't know that that was an option.
I didn't either, so I'll find out the week of May 1st, because we will be at Knit for Knit Night, and Cheryl's holding it for me, because I can't get
there. It's the end of the semester. Wedding, she's crazy.
The end of the semester. I'm trying to get the roots done. I may do that down in Avalon.
You trust them? They screwed up last time you tried to get done down there.
No, they don't do cuts very well, but color's not terrible. I have to think about this, because my appointment tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. was canceled. That's the sad news of the whole thing.
Yeah.
So anyway.
But yeah, so that's what I've been working on quite
assiduously.
And I'm very excited that it's happening. It was very funny. I was texting with my friend Emily. And I kept on saying, oh, I should buy my plane tickets. Oh, I should buy my plane tickets. And she goes, yes, you should, considering you're coordinating all of this. And we know it's going to happen. Buy your damn tickets. I was like,
okay.
You're right. I should.
And so
Yeah. So she and I are rooming together, actually.
Oh, good. And that'll be fun.
Yeah. So we ended up actually getting the 6:30 a.m. flights
together?
At the same time.
Oh, good.
Or similar times, because she's flying to Philly, and her flight, I think, is like
so
legitimately 3 minutes later than mine. So we'll get the same taxi.
Perfect.
I'm also trying to coordinate with T-Knit Pearl
to do that. We're
going to
have to be at the airport at 4 a.m.
We're thinking 5. We're thinking leave the hotel at 4:30, get there at 5.
See how far away the airport is.
It's a half hour, 40 minutes.
All right.
So get there by 5, and yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we've talked about this.
Okay.
T-Knit Pearl is thinking about taking the same flight, and she's like, I'm just going to stand there and laugh at you. And I'm like, good. Good. I'm glad. As long as you make sure that I get on the right plane, that's all I care about.
That's right.
Because I don't function in the mornings that early very well.
What did she do when she was little?
I functioned?
Oh, God, you were awake, you were lively, you were running around the house. It's like, oh, my God, yes,
see,
you
now
function.
That's you, though.
I know.
You're up, and it's like, okay, what are we going to do today?
Well, see, I acclimated myself to you, and,
yeah,
and you changed.
And I acclimated myself to Father.
Yes, so, you know, whatever.
But yeah, I think that's where we're at. I think we're both just trying to get
well, stuff. This is done,
that's
which is
done,
good.
Which
we're
is
gonna
awesome.
Go. I'm gonna go to Michael's right now. Put my blue jeans on, put my light hiking boots on, and go to Michael's, get this, so that's ready.
Mm-hmm.
And my owl, all I have to do is write it up. It's gonna be for divination.
Nice.
As it is my dream to do this. And I've got 5 things to grade for tonight, but that's tonight, so that's fine. I haven't finished fixing that sweater that I found the drop stitch, but I'll also do that tonight.
Good plan.
I picked up my loose needles from downstairs, so I'm not going to lose anything.
That's a good plan.
Yes. And as usual, you know, it would be good to finish more whips so I get more of my needles back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, your rolls are looking pretty sparse.
Well, now there's 3 that are up there underneath your iPad to go back in.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's about it. I think it's time to weave in those ends that
probably.
You have.
Probably, yeah.
So I did weave in my ends on this, but yes
I'll but I haven't blocked yet.
That's true.
Yes.
That's true. Anyway, time to weave in our ends.
And we'll talk to
see you
later.
In 2 weeks.
Yep.
Bye-bye. Bye.